Hello students, my name is Satnam Singh and I welcome you all on this online platform of Sandeepni Gurukul. Students, today we are going to understand one of the very important topic, which is going to be Bent's rule. Now, what is this Bent rule and how important it is, we are going to understand. So students, in Bent's rule they say more electronegative element prefers to stay at what? At axial position, whereas lone pair prefers to stay at which position? At equatorial position. So students, if I take example of what? See here what I'm taking ClF3. तो स्टूडेंट्स, यहाँ पर जो एग्जाम्पल मैंने लिया है वो है ClF3 का. सबसे पहली बात स्टूडेंट्स, यहाँ पर मैं देखेंगे कि सेंट्रल एटम कौन सा है. तो यहाँ पर जो सेंट्रल एटम है वो है क्लोरीन. सो स्टूडेंट्स, क्लोरीन इज व्हाट? इट इज हैलोजन. सो आई राइट 7 ओवर हियर बिकॉज इट बिलोंग्स टू ग्रुप 17. तो इट विल हैव 7 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दी वैलेंस शेल. सो आई हैव रिटन 7 ओवर देयर. Now what is the side atom over there? It is also a halogen, that is fluorine. And fluorine will share only one electron. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put -3 over there. Chlorine contains 7 electron in its outermost shell and fluorine, 3 fluorines are sharing one electron each over there. So what is going to happen is here you will be getting it as what? 4 electron. So students, 4 electron is going to be what? It is going to be 2 lone pair. Chlorine is having 7 electron in its valence shell and fluorine side atom, it can share only what? 1 electron. So 7-3, okay, is going to give you what? It is going to give you 4 electron. 4 electron means what students? It is 2 lone pair. Now we will be calculating the hybridization over here. So students, here it is 3 sigma bond along with 2 lone pair. The sum is going to be what? It is going to be 5. So it is going to be sp3d hybridization. Hybridization will be what? It will be sp3d hybridization. See students, as you know, it is sp3d hybridization. What is going to be the geometry of this sp3d hybridization? Geometry is going to be trigonal pyramidal. Geometry is going to be trigonal bipyramidal. Yes, geometry is going to be what? It is going to be trigonal bipyramidal. तो स्टूडेंट्स, यहां पर ज्योमेट्री ट्राइगोनल बाइपिरामिडल है. अब क्वेश्चन अराइजेस कि ये ट्राइगोनल बाइपिरामिडल में हम लोन पेयर कहां रखेंगे और ये जो बॉन्ड पेयर है उनको कहां लगाएंगे. सी स्टूडेंट्स, वी नो ट्राइगोनल बाइपिरामिडल इज व्हाट? इट इज गोइंग टू बी लाइक दिस. सी, दिस इज वन इक्वेटोरियल पोजिशन, अनदर इक्वेटोरियल पोजिशन, देर इज वन मोर इक्वेटोरियल पोजिशन. स्टूडेंट्स, हमने लिख दिया यहां पर एक एक्शियल पोजिशन और यहां पर भी हमने लिख दी एक एक्शियल पोजिशन. अब क्वेश्चन अराइजेस कि यहां पर हमारे पास है 3 सिग्मा बॉन्ड, 3 बॉन्ड पेयर और 2 लोन पेयर. तो हम बॉन्ड पेयर को कहां रखेंगे और लोन पेयर को कहां रखेंगे? इसका आंसर हमें मिलता है बेंट्स रूल से. स्टूडेंट्स, बेंट रूल में वो कहते हैं कि मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट प्रेफर टू स्टे एट एक्चुअल पोजीशन. ओके, दे प्रेफर टू स्टे एट एक्चुअल पोजीशन, वेरस लोन पेयर प्रेफर टू स्टे एट विच पोजीशन? इक्वेटोरियल पोजीशन. सो स्टूडेंट्स, हियर हाउ मेनी लोन पेयर्स आर देयर? देयर आर 2 लोन पेयर. ओके, एंड देयर इज गोइंग टू बी 3 बॉन्ड पेयर ओवर हियर. सो मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एटम, सी वी हैव टेकन एग्जांपल ClF3 स्टूडेंट्स. तो इट इज हैविंग 2 लोन पेयर. तो लोन पेयर विल बी ऑक्यूपाइंग विच पोजीशन? इट विल बी ऑक्यूपाइंग इक्वेटोरियल पोजीशन. नाउ वी आर लेफ्ट विद 3 फ्लोरीन. सो बाय डिफॉल्ट वी हैव टू पुट 1 फ्लोरीन ओवर हियर एंड द 2 इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एटम दे विल बी ऑक्यूपाइंग विच पोजीशन? दे विल बी ऑक्यूपाइंग this axial position. So students, this is the shape of ClF3, chlorine trifluoride. This is the shape. What is going to be the shape for this one? It is going to be T-shaped, students. Yes, it is going to have a shape. It is going to have T-shaped structure over here. Okay, because see here students, if you write the structure like this, you'll be wrong. Okay, if you are putting structure as this, then only you are correct as per which rule? As per Bent rule. They say more electronegative element over here. See, there is टू लोन पेयर एंड थ्री फ्लोरीन एटम. तो थ्री फ्लोरीन एटम्स आर कंसिडर्ड एज वॉट, मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव. तो दे आर अक्यूपाइंग विच पोजिशन, दे आर अक्यूपाइंग एक्शियल पोजिशन एंड लोन पेयर दे आर अक्यूपाइंग इक्वेटोरियल पोजिशन. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, द नेक्स्ट थिंग विच वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड. See students, we can even understand this in this particular way. See, when I say it is sp3d hybridization, so you can break it, you can say it is sp2 and pd. Okay, so there were, like you say, it is sp3 and then it is going to be what? It is going to be pd. So here we have written with what? sp2, and over there we have written with pd. See students, here they say more electronegative element prefers to stay at axial position. Why? Because there is 0% which character? There is 0% S character. So students, what I have done is, for this sp3d, I have splitted up it into 3sp2 and 2pd. So here the electronegative element is coming at what? It is coming at axial position. Why? Because there is 0% S character over there. There is which character? There is 0% S character. See students, this is other way of understanding which rule? Bent rule. What bent rule states? It states that more electronegative element will occupy which position? It will occupy axial position, and lone pair will be occupying which position? It will be occupying equatorial position. See here, lone pair is going to occupy equatorial position. Okay, why? Because there is going to be more percent S character. And your electronegative element is occupying which position? It is occupying axial position. Why? Because there is 0% S character. आप देख पा रहे हो इसमें एक भी S नहीं है students. It is PD. Let us take some other example students. See students, here I have taken another examples of what? This sp3d hybridization. इन सबकी hybridization sp3d होगी. Okay, when bond pair are 5 and lone pair is 0, example is going to be PCl5. So how we will draw the structure of PCl5? There will be one Cl here, there will be another Cl over here, here there will be one more Cl, here there will be one more Cl. Students, what if I make it as this? This is PCl5. Students, if I am making this as what? PCl3 and F2. Now, among Cl and F, which one is more electronegative? F is more electronegative. Yes, students, F will occupy which position? It will occupy axial position, whereas chlorine, which is less electronegative, will be occupying equatorial position. So here we will say it is going to be Cl. Here also there is one Cl, here there is one Cl, and here it is going to be F, and here also it is going to be what? It is going to be F over there. Okay students, now the another case is going to be what? It is going to be 4 bond pair and 1 lone pair. Sum is coming to 5. So hybridization is sp3d. Here also we have to find out which one will be occupying which position. So students, here we have one lone pair. We know lone pair will occupy which position? It will occupy equatorial position. So what we are going to do for SF4, see here axial position is occupied by more electronegative. Still we are left with some electronegative. So what we will be doing, we will be putting them at what? At equatorial position, as we don't have any choice. But the lone pair will again occupy what? It will occupy which position? It will be occupying equatorial position. See, this geometry, this particular shape is called what? It is called seesaw shape. Yes, the shape is going to be what? It is going to be seesaw shape. Now students, we are going to take another example which we already discussed. See, there is Cl. Here more electronegative element ko pehle hi humne equatorial position pe laga diya, but phir bhi hamare paas ek electronegative element bacha hai. So students, wo electronegative element ko hamare paas choice nahi hai, so humne usko equatorial pe lagaya, and then baki bache lone pair ko bhi humne kahan laga diya? Equatorial pe. Students, main baat kya hai? Aapko jo electronegative element hai usko axial pe rakhna hai, aur और जो लोन पेयर है उसको आपको इक्वेटोरियल पोजीशन पे देना है. ओके, बट यहां पर इक्वेटोरियल पोजीशन, सी एक्चुअल पोजीशन कितनी है? एक्चुअल पोजीशन दो ही है, बट इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट कितने हैं? तीन. तो पहले हमने वो दो इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट को यहां रखा, बाकी बचे मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट को एक इक्वेटोरियल पोजीशन पे लगा दिया, और लोन पेयर को तो हमें रखना ही इक्वेटोरियल पोजीशन पे है. यस स्टूडेंट्स, इसका शेप क्या है? इट इज गोइंग टू बी व्हाट? इट इज गोइंग टू बी योर टी शेप. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, वन मोर एग्जांपल व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू टेक, इट इज गोइंग टू बी योर ज़ेनॉन फ्लोराइड. See students, here it is XeF2. It is a case where they contain what? It is having only two bond pair and three lone pair. Two bond pair and three lone pair. So there are three lone pair, and then there is going to be what? It is going to be two bond pair. See students, the sum is 5. Hybridization is sp3d. Geometry is going to be what? It is going to be trigonal bipyramidal. But here, see, there is xenon. Okay, there is going to be which position? Students, this is which position? This is your axial position. Okay, the more electronegative element, fluorine, has occupied which position? It has occupied axial position. And the equatorial position has been occupied by a lone pair. Equatorial position has been occupied by what? Lone pair. So what is going to be the shape over here? Shape is going to be what? It is going to be linear. So students, by taking various example, here I have taught you all Bent's rule. Hope you'll have understood with the rule. Thank you for watching the video.